Let's see. You know, I was kind of glad that the game unfolded the way it did. I think you got some good footage and some good lessons in that first half, you know, with the guys were really struggling to guard their three-point shot. And we faced some guys before, you know, that were able to pick and pop. The bigs were able to shoot it, so that's a challenge that we didn't know was coming. Well, we did it with this game a little bit, but they didn't guard it well, so we kept going under the ball screen, but enough of the details. The point is, we got some good stuff to go back and say, hey, this is how we told you how to guard it, and you didn't do it. And we told you they could shoot. It wasn't about, you know, whether they could make shots or not. We knew they could make shots. They had three or four guys shot over 40% at the junior college level, so we knew they could shoot the ball. I mean, that's the only way that team beats you, if they can, you know, knock down a whole lot of threes. I think they had seven in the first half. That's too many. We don't want to give up a 1-6-year-old game to a team like that. So, again, the way it unfolded, I think it was good to see how, you know, challenge them a little bit and see how they're going to respond. And I thought that was good, and they did a good job of paying attention to the details that we gave them at halftime and came out and executed a lot better. Like all teams, I think at the beginning of the year, they're motivated by the offense. And I think we got to make sure that this team is motivated by the defense. We've been talking about running so much in practice and really driving that home, that we got to make sure we do a balanced job and an equal amount of teaching about defensive pride and intensity, because we have a lot of slippage in that area, especially in the fundamental sub-techniques.